You're watching Four, and you're about to watch Light Lunch.
Hello, I'm Charlene from Guildford. Eating an upside-down lunch today, pop princess Kylie Minogue and saucy Selena from Summer Bay. Cue titles, mate.
See him, we love him.
Roy! But pretty for maidens, I'm Mel.
Which, in the general scheme of things, means that I have to be Sue. Today on Light Lunch, I have to tell you right now, this minute, that we are overcome with excitement.
We are weak. Weak-kneed with anticipation.
I am quivering with awe.
Positively sweating with suspense.
I can smell it, and now I'm sensing it.
Good.
That is sweat on cloth, that is.
Now, you're probably gasping to know just what it could be that has upended our apple cart so spectacularly. Well, here's a few clues.
Clue number one, she was born in Bethlehem. Not in a lowly cattle shed. No, it's Bethlehem, Australia. Okay.
Clue number two. In the late 80s, she was responsible for naming an entire generation of Essex girls.
So it's somebody called Sharon, then. Clue number three. Worldwide, she's had 25 top 20 hits over the last 10 years.
Can you guess who it is yet?
Can you guess who it is yet?
Can you guess? I've turned into John Noakes.
Hello there.
Can you guess who it is yet?
If I turned into John Noakes, I'd be doing this with your buttocks. He's a strange man, that man. Now, assuming you haven't, now Mel and I have racked our brains, like that, to come up with a suitable tribute for the one, the only, Kylie Minogue! Kylie! 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 Minogue!
Minogue!
Now, I'm sure she's going to be thrilled with that.
Well, no, really, she will be totally and utterly underwhelmed.
OK, so brace yourself for this festival of mediocrity. Here it is, our Terpsichorean tribute to a pop princess.
What?
Terpsichorean.
What's that?
Don't ask me what it means, I just like saying it. Terpsichorean.
For Pete's sake.
No, you mean the dance
routine. Oh, the dance.
The dance. The tassels and the
dancing.
Thong. The dancing, you know, the stuff that we've rehearsed all morning. Here you go, our tribute to Kylie.
That you'll be mine, I'm dreaming. That you're in love with me, like I'm in love with you. But dreaming's all I do. If only they come true, I should be so lucky, 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 lucky. I should be so lucky, lucky. I should be so lucky, lucky, not lucky, lucky. I should be so. Non-stop dancing the bus stop to the funky music. Hustle, pumping the muscle, blame it on the boogie. Remember the old days. Remember the OJs. Walking in rhythm. Life is for living.
Yeah.
conversation.
I'm so sorry for that, mate.
That is okay.
Well,
I better rush in and, you know, give my able assistance as I've done that kind of thing.
You've got your microphone on, so that's
I just, that was it. That's my performance, and you guys are going to cook.
We're
going
to cook for you.
Will you come out lunch later?
I will.
Will you do that?
I will.
Good, Jim.
How much is Kylie? Round of applause! She's small, but she's packed with stardom, that's all I'm saying. She's pint-sized, but she's perfectly formed.
Yeah. And sizzling. Sizzling in. I can't believe she just came in.
She's just done the song with Kylie Minogue.
It's Kylie Minogue. I'm all out of breath. And...
That was lovely, that noise.
Sizzling in later with Antipode and Afters will be Tempany Deckett from Home and Away.
Yeah.
She's the Melbourne peach who plays saucy Selena from Summer Bay.
So on today's show we say... Good day, yum, yum. Thank you. Groan there from Katie. She works with us. That's how bad it was. Now, if you've got a question for Kylie, like, how exactly do you step back in time without the aid of complex machinery and Stephen Hawking? Or will we ever see you back on Ramsay Street? Then call us. Call us now on 09904 lunch. Or if you have an alphabetised phone, that is 09904 45.
Good days.
86.
Prawns on the Barbie.
24.
Times I've thought that Helen Daniels looks like an extra from Planet of the Apes. Or fax us, why don't you now do it? Fax us if you have an alphabetized fax on 09902 lunch. That's 09902 45.
Australian soap stars who've left to pursue pop careers.
86.
Times I've auditioned for the bouncer part only to be pipped to the post by a golden retriever.
24.
Albums sold in total by Craig McLachlan. Now it's time to enlist the athletic support of our boy band. They're small, they're round, and they like nothing better than stacking themselves on top of each other and wrapping themselves in paper. It's Steve, it's Matt, it's Dylan, it's Dan. God save the Queen, I've gone mad. It's the Sex Pastels!
He's invented tasty treats for Julia Carling and the immortal Meredith Hughes. What's more, he's roasted with Rick Stein, marinated with Mozzerman, and washed up with Azza Wazza Tozza. Now he's introduced confit to conferences as he looks after the famously long lunches taken by the creme de la creme of the City of London. Please give him a handsome welcome. He's handsome. It's Peter Kerwood! Cooking, mate.
Well, it's something very trendy and it's very low fat, very healthy.
Right.
I am, in fact, cooking clear Bloody Mary crab risotto.
Hey, I think we should say clear Ruddy Mary risotto.
Ruddy.
It is daytime.
Not
clear
bloody.
Ruddy Mary risotto with crab.
Very tasty.
It's Kylie recommended.
It certainly is. Do you want me to tell you what I'm going to do?
Good, Jim. Right, what are the ingredients, mate?
It's all here. I've got tomatoes, got a crab. I've got vegetables. I've got sweet potatoes. Really, really tasty. And that sweet little thing. That's a butternut squash.
Is that what it is?
And it's very tasty.
Looks like a sort of comedy light bulb.
It
does.
Twist it.
Okay.
And
lovely.
That's potato.
Right.
And I've got ground almonds. Ground almonds, really, really tasty. Olive oil and white wine, and a little bit of celery salt.
Celery
salt. So
I'm
going to put in this. Do you want to do it?
Yeah, yeah.
Shall
go for it. Just one thing before we start. Risotto, Peter, but no rice.
No, it's in inverted commas.
It's a risotto.
I'm afraid so.
Okay.
A bit trendy.
How are your armpits, Peter?
They're not too bad. Can you see sweaty bits?
No,
there?
You're fine. He blow dried them before we came on. They're looking fine. No,
yeah,
they're looking all right.
If I sweat, tell me.
Doll, you're beautiful. Go right ahead.
All right, what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut this one in half to start off with. But what you do is you just literally just shove all these in here.
Just like that.
Just like that. Just not all of them, just some of them.
No messing.
And then you sort of turn it into strawberry. Can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah, you're fine, Dolly.
Turn it into strawberry milkshake type looking thing, you know.
Right.
Chop that like that. And then
we're doing it together.
Yeah, that's lovely, isn't it?
It's good.
It's all teamwork.
Yeah, lovely. Should we switch it off now?
Yeah, that's great. And what I've done here is so I've got a J-cloth that's been sterilised. And what we're going to do is we're going to pour...
What do you mean? Was it something before?
Well, it was basically...
What were you using it before that you had to sterilise it?
Well, it was nothing, but it's just you have to sterilise it because it's healthy.
Hygiene at all times.
What you do is you pour it in here. And what this does, Kay, is it makes it clear. It's great. So you leave it in there and it takes about,
few hours or overnight even, you know. So it's one of those recipes you've got to sort of plan ahead. And what you do is you just...
Okay.
What cut you do
to,
is you just...
Cut to Tuesday.
Yeah, maybe sorry, you're right.
Maybe we're ready.
bit of sunny salt in there.
All right, Dolly.
And then you leave it. Can you see it sort of dripping through?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, sort no, of. It's not, is it? Look. It's now. It's great, isn't it?
Nothing.
So I'll put it over here and
nothing is in there at all,
eventually
Peter.
It'll go.